Okay, couple of things that, you know, I would like to set as a context before I start. Few of our experiences over last 7 years, both in India, in the region of Asia Pacific. Number one, we don't assess that there is another place of a volume player in the market for manufacturing. That space has been taken, let's accept it. That means another country getting into another huge amount of volume production and manufacturing, there is no space for that. That means we have to elevate our game. And I agree with what Mrs. Kelker just mentioned. That means we have to go for smarter products in the market. That means we have to create our own value and intellectual property. We have been, and I'm talking on behalf of small and medium business segment here, we have heard this lamentation for a long time that we cannot hold our margin and profitability. I don't think margin and profitability goes with volume manufacturing, because there is somebody else out there who's going to be cheaper than us. I think the cost arbitrage advantage that we had for a long, long time is eroding, and eroding very, very fast. So we have to create our space, and we have the right opportunity. Again, I would like to quote my previous speaker, where she mentioned that they have reduced their average manpower age from 45 to 35. And the reason is, I think they have taken people who understand computers, who understand software, who know their mathematics and physics, who have a smarter way of doing things, which can be done faster, better, more efficient, and therefore they can help a company address the new needs in the value chain. With that, let me make a statement. Digitalization is changing everything. Whether we realize it, whether we recognize it, it is changing and it will continue to change. And we have a couple of examples right in front of us. More and more people are buying online today than they bought ever on the shop. They listen to music. How long it has been since we have bought a CD in the market for listening to music last, or searching for, you know, the right address to do business with using Yellow Pages. Last but not the least, of course, the ride sharing. What does it say? It says a few things. The largest hotel chain in the world does not own a hotel. The largest shop in the world does not own a shop. The largest taxi company in the world does not own a taxi. So the business models are changing, and it is changing in manufacturing as well. And that is why we have to recognize the disruptive technologies. And I would use these 10 minutes to quickly share with you, put the framework, what Mrs. Kelker just mentioned, as to what could be a framework we can assess ourselves. Even the smallest of the company can implement automation, can implement smarter way of doing things, so that we can do the first time right, reduce waste, and be efficient, and be part of a global value chain as far as competition is concerned. So that's the idea today. But before that, just listen to this video. Can I have the volume, please? So let's look at what is a value chain in any organization today. We have design. Then once we have designed, we do manufacturing. And once we have do manufacturing, we sell it to our customer. I would like to again quote my previous speaker. They are getting more and more RFQs. The days of build to print is over. I heard many CEOs standing on the stage and saying, I don't want a discussion with my supplier where he comes and says, give me a drawing and I'll make a component. They are going to give us more specifications. We have to bid for it in a global market. We have to win that business, and then we have to maintain our margins in that. That means managing our product development and manufacturing, balancing between margins and cost, is going to be extremely critical. Then on top of being innovative with our product development. Point two, whenever we are manufacturing, we have to be flexible in our manufacturing. Another slide I would like to highlight, Mrs. Kelker showed you on additive manufacturing or 3D printing, which is known as additive manufacturing, as opposite of subtractive. When we remove metal, here we add metal. Think through, sirs, I'm sure many, many engineers are sitting here. the way we design the product will change because we are going to into additive manufacturing. The fact the product looks like a product is not because it was designed like that, because that is how it could have been manufactured. Think about it. So there will be a time when 20 components will be reduced to one, because you don't need those 20 components anymore. You don't need to develop 20 tools or 20 forging tools and stamping tools and dies and stuff for it anymore, because you will be depositing material now. So the entire way we have been taught engineering in terms of design and manufacturing is going to change, and we have to be ready for it because somebody else will be otherwise. Point three, we have a very, very important message here, because customer is going to decide the fate of a product based on its quality. Therefore, it is extremely important that we track how our product is doing with the customer. And that's where the new technologies of sensors and IoT and cloud are going to be important in the market. Whenever we sell anything, it doesn't matter whether it's a ceiling fan or a very large engine, there will be enough data coming out of it which will give us the analytics, which will tell us how the product is doing, tell us in advance which part is about to fail, so that we don't get into a maintenance scheduling anymore. It would be intelligent predictive scheduling of maintenance, which will prevent from that failure to even happen. All the companies, all the products in the world today are working towards maintenance-free life of a product, except, of course, very, very long life cycle products like a ship or an aircraft or a, you know, fighter aircraft. They are looking at, for example, in automobile, building tires that need not be changed or checked for pressure and whatever else between the two subsequent service cycles. So these require a lot more intelligent product development, just as an example. If we take these three status, we are looking at three stages of ideation, realization, and utilization, which means design, manufacturing, and service age when it is with the customer. And if we put all the three together, the entire value chain, which needs to be looked at by all of us in this community, is product design, production planning, production engineering, production execution, and services. This is what we do. We design, we create bill of material, engineering bill of material. We plan, we create manufacturing bill of material and resources and what all tools and what all resources we need. Then we plan our manufacturing automation on the shop floor. Then I manufacture and regulate it in terms of getting the data out of the shop floor to know whether my operational efficiency, productivity, quality is online. And then I sell to the customer and I track through the services. This entire value chain, if we can digitalize, that is the control digital technologies will give us. And we can reduce our innovation cycle, because as I said, the continuous innovation, like Grindmaster, who just mentioned that innovation is in their bones, extremely important that how do we develop processes. I was just talking to a lady, a small and medium business segment entrepreneur before this session, and I mentioned it to her, technology anybody can buy, machine anybody can buy, you can get the best brains from the market giving him good salary, but the processes for yourself only you can create for yourself. So that is where a definition of digitalization would be, as Mr. Raju mentioned, and Mrs. Kelkar, that Industry 4.0 or the Indian version of it, whatever you want to call it, has to be not one shirt that fits all. We have to decide what is important for us, what are the critical areas, how the critical areas needs to be addressed, introduce technology and automation for those critical areas and track them. Because without measurement, you do not know whether improvement has happened or not. Okay, so that's the mantra. If we can keep in mind this value chain of these five steps and ask ourselves, have I got a digital way of defining my product? If yes, have I got a digital way of defining my process? If yes, have I got a digital way of implementing automation? If yes, have I got the digital way of acquiring data from the shop floor? A sensor costs you 150 rupees, gentlemen and ladies. It is not expensive. I think the word we have to tell ourselves, we very quickly say it is very expensive. I think we have to change the word to how valuable it is for us. What is the return that I can expect? We are all businessmen, entrepreneurs. Instead of expenses, we have to look at how good is the investment and then figure out which areas of this value chain we would like to invest in. That's it. My point was simple. I have a very, very long presentation after this. If you give me 4 hours, I can keep you in sitting here, but I shall not. This is the last slide. If you want to go deeper in any one of these areas of design, manufacturing, automation, I have the details with me. Thank you for the opportunity, sir. If you have any questions at the end of the session, I'll be glad to answer. Thank you.